The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello everyone. With a warm wish, I am back. How are you all? Doing good? My sincere wishes and prayers for you and your family. Yes, for a change, today I am going to begin this session with a short story. I know many of you would have read this story earlier, but still, every now and then when you listen to these stories that gives you life lessons, it is well and good. We get reminded about the values that we get lost and that we have to bring it up again for the need of an equilibrium in society. A very short story, okay? Once there lived a woman in a village. She baked chapatis for all the members of her family and an extra chapati for a hungry passerby. Every day she kept this chapati in the windowsill and a hunchback came and he picked it up. And she waited for a gratitude from that man in return. But what he did is, instead of giving a word of thanks, he said the following words: "The evil you do remains with you. The good you do comes back to you." This was the statement that he said every day after taking this chapati. For days together, the same action happened. She kept the chapati on the windowsill and the hunchback came, took it, repeated the same jingle again and again. One day she got highly irritated and she wanted to put a stop, full stop to this action. Raging with anger within her, what she did was that she added poison to the chapati that she prepared for this man, an extra chapati for this man, and she kept in the windows. The moment when she was about to keep it on the windowsill, her hands trembled. She felt annoyed of herself, and what she did, she took the chapati back and she burned it in the fire. And she baked a fresh chapati and kept it there. As usual, this hunchback came and took the chapati and went back, repeating the same jingle. What? The evil you do remains with you and the good you do comes back to you. Okay. But when every day this lady was then, when this woman was keeping this chapati on the windowsill, she kept a prayer for her son too. Her son has left home long back to a faraway country to gain fortune. Until then, he has not reached home back, and it was a prayer for her son. And one day, she heard a knock at her door. She opened the door. To her surprise, it was her son who was standing in tattered, torn clothes very thin and weak. And the moment when this boy, the son, saw his mother, he said, "Mom, it's a miracle that I stand in front of you, because on my way back, I was too hungry and I was about to collapse and fall down. But I happened to meet a hunchback who gave me a chapati, and that has helped me to reach home." And he even said that was the chapati that he takes every day. And he had a good mind that he could give the whole chapati to me, and I felt so happy about it. Right now, the action, what she did to me. What flashed in her mind was that poison, the chapati she was about to keep on the windows. And now she realized the meaning of the words that was uttered by this hunchback. What was it? The evil you do remains with you, and the good you do comes back to you. Now she understood the meaning, why he kept repeating the same words. She regretted a lot. She felt bad about a lot. Okay, the story ends like this. So now what I would like to tell you is that, dear children, keep doing good to everyone, unmindful of what you get back. One day or the other, you will be appreciated. Don't wait for appreciation every now and then. Nobody is ready to grant or give you appreciation immediately. So, wait for a good day that comes and knocks at your door. So, don't worry to do good. Be happy to help others, because the good you do comes back to you. And the evil you do remains with you. Okay, children, now my question is, what made that lady, that woman, to mix or add poison to the chapati? Yes, she was raging in anger. She was expecting something in return. Okay. What was the quality that she was lacking in? Yes, you are right. Love towards fellow beings and love towards humanity was lacking in this, isn't it? So, let me ask you, don't you feel that love towards humanity is much necessary and essential to be in the society, to live in this community? As man is a social animal, isn't it? Am I not right? So, let me begin to the next unit, which is slightly at least connected to the story what I have said, right? Heights of harmony. Harmony, have you heard this word? Yes. It is normally used in the field of music, harmonious, isn't it? The blending of notes, because each notes have different tune, tone, but all these notations should blend with each other to give you a good, pleasant, melodious music to you. So, heights of harmonies. Harmony should be not only in music, but also in our life. Is it? And our India is known for its unity in diversity. Am I not right? Yes. So, let me begin the lesson or the poem, Many Before.
Yes, it is about mending the wall. Earlier we said about the humanitarian ground that is much essential in all human beings, isn't it? So, mending the wall, you know wall? You love walls? Do you like or dislike walls? We have various reasons to love walls and also dislike walls, isn't it? Why do you love a wall? If you love a wall, what might be the reasons? Yes, it is a support. It gives you security. It is a boundary for you. It protects you, isn't it? It gives you various reasons for you to love a wall. You dislike wall? You hate walls? Yes, even for that we have plenty of reasons. Why do we hate a wall? Because it is a boundary. Boundary, a discrimination. Isn't it? Okay, let me ask you one thing. You have a fencing at your home. We have heard of plenty of cases, plenty of issues in connection with this fencing. We have come across many fights with our neighbors, with whom we have to live very peacefully, harmoniously, lovingly. To those people, we stand for a fight. Not only with neighbors, even in our family, among the family members, we would have come across so many fights, quarrels in the name of this fence, fencing. So, mending the wall. I said the poem is not about mending a wall. To attract the attention of the readers, he has given you a title about mending. Mending, repair. When you live with your neighbors, you know, how is your relationship with your neighbors? Is it very cordial, loving? You share things with them, you share your food, you join them for all the festivals, all the occasions, you play together. All these things have been stopped right now. We all have big walls to separate us. To keep your home neat and clean, what you do is you throw the garbage of your house to the next house. So you have turned to be a selfish person. You need only your happiness. You don't think about your neighbors. The main reason is you have a wall. So it speaks about, as you have said earlier, this humanitarian ground, this love, affection for brotherhood has to be insisted and strengthened. So this mending wall stands as a big call for this young youth. You have to think about it. This poem is written by Robert Lee Frost. You have heard about him? Yes, he is an American poet. Two well-known poems, what I could say is Road Not Taken and Stopping by the Woods in the Snowy Evening. You see, when I have to say about Road Not Taken, each and every young chap should read this poem. It's highly inspiring and motivating. He sees how important is taking a decision at a crucial moment. And finally, you turn to be a successful person. Normally, Robert Lee Frost's poem begins with delight and ends with wisdom. To make his living, he has tried so many jobs, being a teacher, a poet, playwright, farmer, and even an editor. And finally, he was successful as a poet. So Robert Frost's poem is all highly delightful, and finally you get a lesson. You learn some knowledge, cementing the wall. And this wall, the wall that Robert Frost speaks about, is not a cemented wall, okay? It is a rough wall that is not cared by anybody else. It is a wall. It's not a cemented wall. Okay, shall we begin the poem? Okay, we'll begin with the intro first. Fraternity and tolerance are the twin virtues of a harmonious living. Fraternity and tolerance. Tolerance, you know, being patience, having patience with your fellow beings. Fraternity, brotherhood, considering everybody in this universe to be a family, your family member, that brotherhood, are the twin virtues for a harmonious living. Don't you agree with it? Now, if you think about what's happening in the society, we feel ashamed of our life. Each one kill others in the name of caste, creed, religion, or even about the politics. Everything comes as a discrimination or as a wall, as a barrier. So, fraternity and tolerance are the twin virtues of harmonious living. But do we cherish these qualities in our daily life? Do we have these qualities? When you sit along with your friends in the classroom, you entertain this. You don't mind about your friend being a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian. Nothing else. You have only one thing. My friend. So develop this quality. Develop this attitude. Even when you are old. Let us not be tormented by the name of religion. What should be our attitude to our neighbors? What should be the attitude? Having envy or having good relationship? Nowadays, neighborhood, neighbors, we have turned to be competitors. If one buys a fridge, the other one goes to buy a double door fridge. If a vehicle, if a two-wheeler, the next one is a four-wheeler. So we turn to be competitors for each other. We don't have a mind to strengthen our bonding and have love and affection with others. Need we accept their ideas as well in order to maintain good relationship with them? No. We have to admit this. Now, it is a poem by Robert Frost that provides food for thought. You empower yourself, your body, by giving food to your body, isn't it? You create a good immune system for your body, that you don't get affected by anything, any disease. The same way, you have to strengthen up your mind too. You have to give good food for your thought. So at times when you come across good ideas, accept it and start cultivating that habit in your life. Okay, So this mending wall. Mainly when we hear the word wall, what comes to our mind is like restrictions, barrier, hindrance, discriminations, isn't it? So everything gets limited within the space. You cannot explore. So such a wall has to be mended. Mending, repairing. So shall we begin with the poem? Even the first line is so catchy. Something there is that doesn't love a wall. In the beginning we have said so many reasons that we love a wall. So to give more strength to what he wants to express, he begins the first line with a statement telling, something's there that doesn't love a wall, that sends a frozen ground swell under it and spills the upper boulders in the sun and makes gaps even two can pass abreast. The work of the hunters is another thing. I have come after them and made repair where they could have left not one stone on a stone. But they would have the rabbit out of hiding. To please the yelping dogs, the gaps I made. No one has seen them made or heard them made. But at spring mending time, we find them there. I let my neighbor know beyond the hill. And on a day, we meet to walk the line. And set the wall between us once again. We keep the wall between us as we go. To each the boulders that have fallen to each. And some are loaves and some so nearly balls. We have to use a spell to make them balance. Stay where you are until our backs are turned. We wear our fingers rough with handling them. Oh, just another kind of outdoor game. One on a side, it comes to little more. There, where it is, we do not need the wall. He is all pine and I am apple orchard. My apple trees will never get across and eat the cones under the pines, I tell him. He only says, good fences make good neighbors. Spring is a mischief in me and I wonder if I could put a notion in his head. Why do they make good neighbors? Isn't it? Where there are cows. But here there are no cows. Before I built a wall, I would ask to know where I was walling in or walling out. And to whom I was like to give offense. Something there is that doesn't love a wall, that wants it down, I could say yells to him. But it's not yells exactly, and I would rather he said it for himself. I see him there, bringing a stone, grasped firmly by the top. In each hand, like an old stone savage art. He moves in darkness, as it seems to me. Not of woods only, and the shades of trees. He will not go behind his father's saying, and He likes having thought of it so well. He says again, good fences make good neighbors. We have read the poem, and I would like to quote wordings of Isaac Newton. Men build too many walls, but not bridges. You got the point? Walls, it disconnects you from others. Bridges, it connects you to people. That is not, is it not thought-provoking? Men build so many walls, but not too many bridges. We are not interested in building bridges. We need only walls. And even if I have to speak about relationship with people, relationship never meets its natural death. It is always kill or murder. Don't you agree with that? So, saying this, I would like to stop right now, and I'll meet you next week. Thank you.